In southern New South Wales, experiments have been underway for the past 5 years to answer the question, will grain growers see the full benefits of stubble retention and controlled traffic while ever sheep graze those stubbles, remove ground cover and trample the soil? Well, Ground Cover TV found the answer.
When GRDC supports research, the expectation is the outcomes will result in change on farm. Change such as the adoption of a new variety or new technology. In this story, the surprise result is a recommendation not to change, as long as everyone keeps to the rules, and it's surprising for a number of reasons. But first, let's go back to the experiment, which took place here at Tamora and was replicated at Condobolin.
We set up this experiment with FarmLink Research where we were comparing three strategies, if you like. So complete stubble retention, so no sheep going in there at all, and then grazing the stubble. So after harvest, the sheep would go in and we'd graze the stubbles down to a level we thought was reasonable, and then also grazing the crop during the winter and the stubbles as well.
The experiment was to scientifically measure the impact sheep have on stubble paddocks. This region is very productive and often results in heavy stubble loads after harvest. Grazing off those stubbles has been common practice. The straw is a good source of carbohydrates and protein, and the sheep had other uses.
Historically, I guess we've considered them, or thought they were a good weed control over the summertime. Any rainfall events that did occur, the sheep were there to control the weeds when they were young. And also it was a great feed value for the sheep over that time. It gave the pastures a break over the summertime. So it was, the land was there, we used it, utilised it for the livestock.
However, the move to farming systems that reduced soil compaction by controlling paddock traffic and retained stubble to improve soil health and moisture retention had the mixed business farmers asking questions about the level of impact their sheep were having and how that affected the next season's crops. Farmers like Michael Sinclair started to keep sheep off the stubble, especially after the run of dry years from 2000 on.
We realised then that the sheep weren't actually controlling the weeds. They were still there. The roots were still active, dragging moisture out. So that was the reason for pulling the sheep off the stubble, or not letting the sheep on the stubbles over the summertime, and turning to chemical control of the weeds to get a definite kill.
However, when the rains returned, so did the heavy crop residues, and the sheep were put back into the stubbles. Around the same time, GRDC's Water Use Efficiency Initiative got underway. And as part of that program, James Hunt and his research colleagues at FarmLink and New South Wales DPI established their experiments. Now, as the trials are being finalised, the various questions are being answered.
The thing about sheep compaction as opposed to machinery compaction is very deep because of the weight and the width of the footprint of a tyre, whereas sheep compaction, because the hooves are quite small, it's only ever very shallow. And so just the act of sowing with our knife points and press wheels basically breaks up that compaction, and so we never see a negative impact on the crop. And we also measure the crop very closely to see how it's growing in response to that compaction.
As well as compaction, the experiment measured soil moisture levels. These drink cans cover tubes that drop 1.80 metres beneath the surface. Within the tubes, neutron moisture meters were placed to determine whether grazed plots had a greater moisture loss due to runoff or evaporation compared to nil-grazed plots. Also, moisture probes were used at 7.5 and 15 centimetre depths to get a good understanding of water infiltration. Early trial photos show an overgrazed plot from 2009. It was grazed in winter and again after harvest. In comparison, this is the no-graze plot from the same season. The soil water content looked like this.
As you can see, the lines are right on top of each other up in the surface of the soil. And what that really tells us is that the differences that we had between those two treatments weren't due to evaporation. And what it demonstrated was that the extra water we had wasn't due to evaporation, the stubble preventing evaporation. It was due to the stubble cover increasing infiltration. And so the differences in water were down the bottom of the profile. So more water had run in those plots.
stubble and retained crop residues tie up nitrogen. And one of the most interesting outcomes of the experiment was the contribution sheep make to soil nitrogen levels.
When you have sheep grazing stubble, you get a much more rapid nitrogen cycling, and the yield and protein advantages that we've seen from having sheep in the system probably come from that.
At Temora in 2011, at the time of sowing, the different plot treatments produced these levels of available soil nitrogen. In 2012, again, the three different treatments produced three different results. Also measured were yield and grain protein levels.
Yields have been as good or higher in our plots with sheep in them, and our proteins the same compared to the full stubble retention treatment. So this is indicating that biophysically, having sheep in your system doesn't compromise crop yield.
While the Temora experiment was conducted on small plots, the trial at Condobolin was on a paddock scale, and the similar grain and graze program run by the Birchip Cropping Group also produced results that are consistent with the Temora outcomes. And given that nitrogen levels are running down across the southern cropping zone and becoming more of a limiting factor on crop yields, if sheep can positively contribute to a cropping system, the no need to change outcome should give growers confidence and the knowledge that they can get the positive benefits that controlled traffic and stubble retention bring to a farming system. With this proviso:
as long as you obey those rules, which are that you always control summer weeds and you always keep 70% of cover on paddocks at all times, you'll still get good fallow efficiency, so 70% cover is enough to prevent wind erosion, water erosion, and maximise infiltration. So as long as you do that, you can graze sheep on stubbles, but once you start breaking those rules, you will compromise yield.